So we finished oxidation of fatty acid up to this. So you know what is lipolysis, and this is oxidation of fatty acid. Whole fatty acid metabolism occur in these four steps. First, I already discussed lipolysis. Second, I discussed activation of fatty acid, and then also I discussed this mitochondrial transport, that is citrate shuttle. So this is citrate shuttle. I have already explained this. Now let's today talk about beta oxidation. Okay, beta oxidation of fatty acid and regulation of beta oxidation. So what is beta oxidation? Beta is the position of carbon. So this is functional group in fatty acid. This is alpha carbon and this is beta carbon. This oxidation of this carbon, this particular carbon, will lead to break in bond between these two carbon, alpha and beta, and thereby production of acetyl. This two carbon compound called acetyl coenzyme.
Excuse me.
Okay. Yes.
Can you please repeat what you said, like from beta oxidation?
Just tell me what you did not understand.
From the beginning, here, just here.
So can you read here?
Yeah, process of fatty acid oxidation is 10 beta oxidation.
Just then speak up more.
Since it occurs through the sequential removal of two carbon units by oxidation of the beta carbon position of the fatty acid acetyl molecule.
So beta carbon, which is beta carbon? There is alpha carbon, something called alpha carbon, beta carbon, gamma carbon, then alpha, beta, gamma, delta, then epsilon, like that. The numbering goes on. Which carbon do you call alpha carbon?
So a carbon that is attached to a functional group.
Yes. Did you get that? What is functional group? Did you get that? Is it Koshi?
Yes, sir. It got that.
Okay, functional group. Any functional group. I have already explained this alpha, beta, gamma in amino acid only. If you can, you don't remember right now. So any carbon that is attached to here, functional group is carboxy group. So any carbon that is attached to this functional group, this is called, the first carbon is called alpha carbon. Then the carbon that is away from this alpha carbon is beta carbon. This carbon is gamma carbon. When there is extra carbon like this, this would be called delta. This is called epsilon, like that. Numbering goes on. So carbon that is attached to alpha carbon. Alpha carbon is not, this functional group is not given number. The carbon that is attached to alpha carbon is called, that is attached to functional group is called alpha carbon. Carbon that is attached to functional group is called alpha carbon. So that is why you forgot. That is why I have named alpha amino acid. If you can remember, alpha amino acid. This alpha terminology came from the carbon that is attached with functional group. In amino acid, you can say this is acid. And then amino group. Then H and R group. So this is alpha carbon. Yeah, this is alpha carbon. With the carbon that is attached to functional group. So this beta carbon will be oxidized. Okay, this will be oxidized. And because of oxidation of this carbon, this bond will be broken. And breaking of this bond will release this two carbon compound. This two carbon compound is called acetyl coenzyme A. Now, next, the same thing will happen. And this breaking of these two carbon progresses like that. So you can see this. That is why this is called beta oxidation. Every time oxidation of this carbon will lead to this breaking of this bond and release of acetyl coenzyme. That is why this is called beta oxidation. And I told you that this beta oxidation is oxidation of fatty acid. Major oxidation of fatty acid occurs through beta oxidation. And I have already in the beginning explained about the minor that happens in peroxisome and endoplasmic reticulum, minor pathway. So alpha, one type of beta, alpha oxidation and beta, a different type of beta oxidation that happens to a very long chain fatty acid. This beta oxidation happens inside peroxisome, and then omega oxidation happens in endoplasmic reticulum. So remember these three minor pathways. We are talking right now about major pathway of beta oxidation that happens in mitochondria. This beta oxidation happens in mitochondria. So you can see this is the process is very opposite reverse of the palmitic acid synthesis. In palmitic acid synthesis, what happened? There was formation of bond between these two acetyl coenzyme A. You can see this red colored is the bond, representation of bond. And this blue line is representation of acetyl coenzyme A, the unit acetyl coenzyme A. This individual unit are acetyl coenzyme A that was utilized during synthesis of fatty acid. But here, during oxidation of fatty acid, what will happen? There will be break of bond. I told you, formation of bond required two NADH. Now, breaking of bond will also release two equivalent, reducing equivalent molecules similar to two NADPH. So, what are them? I have already discussed. Now, again, bond will break. So, this is one bond breaking between this oxidation. See, this is what? Alpha carbon. This is beta carbon. So oxidation happens here, and this will cause release of bond, and then beta oxidation will release this acetyl coenzyme A. Now again, for this compound, this is beta carbon. So oxidation of this carbon will lead to breaking of this bond again. So this bond between alpha and beta again release acetyl. The same things will happen seven times. As if you can remember this fatty acid oxidation synthesis, the seven times the bond formation requires seven steps. The same way here, bond breaking requires will go up to seven steps. And this seven steps is O-hot reaction. There, I told you this was CRDR reaction in fatty acid synthesis. So RR for reduction. CRDR, RR for reduction. Here, OO, oxidation. So two oxidation steps are there. And there, dehydration, here hydration steps are there. And fourth step is thiolysis. So you can see O hot step will break, two oxidation step will break these bonds. And because of breaking of this two oxidation, there will be release of one FADH2 and one NADH. One FADH2 and one NADH. So how many ATP does it equal? One FADH is equal to how many ATP? So it is equal to 1.5 ATP. This is equal to 2.5 ATP. So total will be 4 ATP equivalent to this. And what was the requirement? What happened? Can you compare this whole event with the fatty acid synthesis? The fatty acid oxidation events with the fatty acid synthesis. So this, consider this is a para, these are the parameters, two parameters. What happens in fatty acid synthesis?
Fatty acid synthesis, fatty acid is created from acetyl-CoA.
Okay, acetyl-coenzyme, two acetyl-coenzyme will here. Bond formation will happen between two acetyl coenzyme. Okay, fatty acid synthesis. So bond formation will happen between. And then what reaction will be there? What are the reaction that will form the bond? There are seven steps of same reaction, similar to this. That reaction you can see here. Breaking a bond, there will be reverse reaction. The reaction would be formation of bond. Isn't this fatty acid synthesis? If you see this way, this is fatty acid breakdown. If you see other way, this is fatty acid synthesis. So it is it depends on you how much time you take to understand. I can go pretty slow. I don't have any problem. Go pretty slow. Spend a whole time on this. It is your responsibility. If you are agile enough, I will go a little fast. Otherwise, like this, I will go like this. Similarly, this is a decent breakdown. Synthesis. I have already explained what is the difference between this fatty acid oxidation and synthesis. Can anyone tell me?
In oxidation, we're turning fatty acid to acetyl-CoA, and in synthesis, we're turning
oxidation, acetyl coenzyme is synthesized. From which compound?
Fatty acid or palmitic acid.
Palmitic acid. So this will be the formation of like this fatty acid alcohol. Okay. So you can see here breaking of bond. Can't you see the breaking of bond here? Breaking of bond. You can see here breaking of bond. Now, opposite processes, fatty acid synthesis, formation of bond, you can see. This formation of bond. Can you see? So, the basic difference is formation of bond in fatty acid synthesis. And fatty acid synthesis happens during fasting condition or fed condition.
It is fed condition.
And fatty acid breakdown?
Fasting condition.
So which type of reaction will be required for formation of bond? Here this bond formation. What type of reaction is required for formation of bond in fatty acid synthesis?
Carboxylation
is formation of a sticky acetyl coenzyme. This bond formation requires what?
For fatty acid synthesis, like you constantly add two carbon yes. Atoms.
What will be required? Yes, tell me, please.
Two carbon atoms is constantly added because of the
reaction. And then constantly adding, and there will be formation of bond. And this bond formation requires which reaction? What type of reaction? Fatty acid breakdown. This is fatty acid synthesis. This, there is, if you can notice, during fatty acid synthesis, there is formation of bond. This bond formation requires what type of reactions? This is fatty acid oxidation. This is fatty acid synthesis. So fatty acid synthesis is formation of bond. And see this. Breaking of bond is there during fatty acid oxidation. Same thing. The opposite reaction is formation of bond. So each formation of bond will require two reducing equivalent. I have already explained you CRDR. Don't you remember this CRDR?
Yes, I do.
So what does this R means? Two R means?
Reduction.
So what do we require for reduction here?
Is it anion?
Anionyl
or something.
NADPH.
NADPH. It requires NADPH. Each formation of bond requires NADPH. Each bond formation requires two NADPH. Two R is there. CRDR. So two NADPH. Will be required. This is a very key reaction that is required for formation of bond. D for dehydration, C for condensation. This is very basic reaction, you can see. This is very basic reaction that is happening. And that will form the bond here. If bond formation required two NADPH, don't forget like this. At least the basic thing, I don't expect you to remember everything, but basic things. So this, now, so each bond formation, you have seen two NADPH is required. Two NADPH is required for each bond formation. So now there will be breaking of bond. During fatty acid oxidation, there will be breaking of bond, this bond. So breaking, each bond will release what? Each bond breaking will release what? What will be released?
CO2.
No CO2. So CO2 is not released during beta oxidation. CO2 is not released during beta oxidation. 2-NADPH is consumed during bond break. Don't you think similar NADPH
NADPH will release.
NADPH like molecule. The NADPH will not release. NADPH will always be required for synthesis only. 2-NADPH like molecule will be released. So we have seen here formation during formation CRDR. So what will be there during breaking? What is the opposite of reduction? Oxidation. Dehydration, hydration. So you can see each step will, for each step there will be two oxidation and one hydration, the thiolysis. So O hot reaction. 7 O hot reaction will happen. And because of this reaction will cause the break of bond between two acetyl coenzyme A. So this will release very similar molecule to NADPH like molecule. So in that two, there will be one FADH2, one NADPH. What is one FADH2? What is one NADH? One FADH2 is equal to 1.5 ATP. One NADH is equal to 2.5 ATP. So there is how you can get from each bond breakage, you will get 4 ATP. So how many ATP do you get from this beta oxidation of palmitic acid? Tell me.
28.
So there are 7 steps, okay? 7 steps. Same. 7 steps for formation of fatty acid, palmitic acid, and 7 steps for breakdown. So 7 steps, each step produce 4 ATP. Then 4 times 7 is equal to 28 ATP. So beta oxidation of this palmitic acid will release 28 ATP. But do you remember 2 ATP is required? Was consumed for which step? During beta oxidation? Two ATP was consumed for activation step. Two ATP was consumed for oxidation step. So that is why NAT activation step. Two ATP was consumed for activation. So don't you remember this 4 step?
Yes, sir.
Lipolysis, then activation. At this step, 2 ATP was utilized. This is the step where ATP is utilized. Other step, there will be production of ATP. So ATP production is there, but this is the only step where ATP is utilized. So NAT production of ATP from beta oxidation from a palmitic acid is 26 ATPH. Okay, so this 26 ATPH will be produced. Now let's say this. So let's talk about this 4-step process. This is O hot process, as I told you, OHOT process. So this step will happen. This step, let's talk about this oxidation, hydration, oxidation, and thiolysis. This 4-step will break the bond between alpha carbon and beta carbon, thereby release of one acetyl coenzyme A per step. So you can see step one is carried out by the enzyme called fatty acid dehydrogenase. Oxidation means dehydrogenase. Now step two, three, and four, this all three step will be done by what? A trifunctional enzyme. Trifunctional. So oxidation will be done by one enzyme. There is different enzyme, one different enzyme. And this three is done by trifunctional HOT reaction. HOT reaction will be done by, O reaction will be done by one enzyme. HOT reaction will be done by one polypeptide containing three enzyme. So let's see this. So there are, you can see this. You can see here, acyl coenzyme A dehydrogenase will remove one hydrogen from here and one hydrogen from here, and between alpha and beta. So one hydrogen from here and one hydrogen from here. So because of removal of one hydrogen from this, there will be insertion of double bond here. You can see insertion of a double bond and removal of one FADS in the first step only. So there is second step. What will happen? This is in an oil. So in oil coin, this is in, one double bond is represented by in, and oil is the acid is given oil. In oil coenzyme A hydratase. So water will be added here. So this becomes hydroxy containing compound, hydroxy acyl coenzyme A. So hydroxy acyl coenzyme in third reaction, this is called oxidation reaction. This is hydration, this is oxidation again. So in oxidation reaction, there will be release of one NADH molecule here by beta hydroxy acyl coenzyme A dehydrogenase. And then there will be fourth reaction. This fourth reaction is removal of this two carbon containing acetyl coenzyme A from this parent chain. So now there is production of one. So one step of beta oxidation happened. So next cycle, this carbon will undergo next cycle of beta oxidation. This way, the cycle of beta oxidation will be seven cycle will be there. And from this seven cycle, there will each cycle, you, I told you, is a O-hot reaction, and this released oxidation has released one oxidation, has released one FADH2, second has released one NADH. So thereby, this both will equal to 4 ATP. And this this enzyme is isolated enzyme, single enzyme, and this is an enzyme. Three enzymes are part of one protein. This is part of trifunctional enzyme. So this is oxidation, this is hydration, this is oxidation, this is thiolysis. So you can see this here. So release of this one acetyl coenzyme is 2, 3. So each bond will release one NADH and FADH2. So there will be seven NADH and seven FADH. This equals 28 ATP from beta oxidation. And now you can see this each acetyl coenzyme A that is produced from this two carbon is, these are acetyl coenzyme representation of acetyl. So each two carbon will contribute to acetyl coenzyme A. And how many ATP does each acetyl coenzyme A equals to? Each acetyl coenzyme A, it has to produce ATP through Krebs cycle or tricarbox TCA cycles. How many ATP will one acetyl coenzyme A will produce? 10 ATPs will be produced from one acetyl coenzyme A. And so you can see here production of 8 acetyl coenzyme A. 7 step, but 8 acetyl coenzyme A. And this 8 acetyl coenzyme A will produce 8 tens of 80 ATP. So 80 ATP plus 26 ATP, because 2 ATP was subtracted, because 2 ATP was utilized in the beginning of this during activation only. So this equals how many ATP? 106 ATP. So one palmitic acid oxidation, if there is complete oxidation of one palmitic acid, this will release 106 ATP. So this much energy one palmitic acid has got. 106 ATP. You can see on this picture. So calculation you can go through. 7 This means this ATP, 7-step disulfide, this means this ATP, 8 acetyl coenzyme A, 18, and then 108, and 2 was utilized in the initial phase of activation of fatty acid. So this will result in 106 moles of ATP. So you can use this formula also, 7 and minus 6, to calculate N. N means number of carbon. So you multiply number of carbon of fatty acid and you can calculate the, if you, it is 18, so you can calculate this way. So multiply with this, subtract 6, so you will get the number of ATP that is obtained from 18 carbon compound. Now just remember this only, palmitic acid will give 106 ATP. So, but what happens in liver? In liver, complete oxidation does not happen. Palmitic acid will convert into acetyl coenzyme A. Okay, palmitic acid will convert into acetyl coenzyme A. One palmitic into 8 acetyl coenzyme A. And there will be release of 26 ATP. And then this acetyl coenzyme A will convert into ketone body. So it will not be oxidized to carbon dioxide through TCA cycle. Rather, this acetyl coenzyme A will form ketone body in liver. This events happen in liver. Did you understand? This is sufficient. This much ATP is sufficient. This much ATP is sufficient for liver functioning. So now let's talk about regulation. So if you can remember, I have already explained about regulation also. So first step, this happens in where does this event happen? The first step happens where?
Adipocytes.
Good. Very good. Very good. So it happens in your adipocytes, the fat that is present all over your subcutaneous tissue and inside your body. It happens in adipocyte. So this will melt this triglyceride. This will melt this triglyceride. And this triglyceride will be converted into glycerol and fatty acid and glycerol by which enzyme? The enzyme called lipase. Which lipase? Hormone sensitive lipase. And you know why is this called hormone sensitive? Because this is activated by glucagon and inhibited by insulin. So from this you can extract one concept. So this is the one regulatory step. This is the first regulatory step. So don't forget this four-step process, okay? If you remember this four-step process, that is the more important thing. I told you this is the most important slide. And then beta oxidation happens through 7-step of OHOT reaction. That is easy. You can see this is very important step. The transportation of, that is called carnitine shuttle. This is very important step. And this is the only step activation where you can see the utilization of ATP. Otherwise, everywhere you will see there is production of enough ATP, about 28 ATP. So 28 ATP minus 2 ATP means net is 26 ATP from beta oxidation. Now you can see this is the first regulatory step and this is the transportation is second regulatory step. This is second regulatory step. This is the must two regulatory step of the oxidation of fatty acid. Must two important regulatory step of the oxidation of fatty acid. So you can see this is, I have also given you one slide. At adipose tissue, lipolysis is under regulation by hormone. Which hormone? Glucagon and insulin. So glucagon will stimulate lipolysis and insulin will inhibit lipolysis. Through which enzyme? HS lipase, hormone sensitive lipase. That is how during fed condition, lipolysis does not happen and beta oxidation does not happen. During fasting condition, lipolysis will happen and beta oxidation will happen. So now see, Second step is the transportation of this fatty acid. And this transportation for transportation of fatty acid, first enzyme is CPT1, carnitine palmitoyl transferase 1. This convert palmitoyl coenzyme A into palmitoyl carnitine. So this CPT1 enzyme is inhibited. This is inhibited by what? By fate condition substrate. What is fate condition substrate? Malonyl coenzyme. This malonyl coenzyme is synthesized from, it is synthesized during fatty acid synthesis. Acetyl coenzyme A will convert into, you know, a sticky acetyl coenzyme, that is malonyl coenzyme A. This malonyl coenzyme A, in fed condition, it is inhibitor of this transportation. Transportation of palmitic acid into mitochondria. And that is how during fed condition, transportation of palmitic acid is inhibited into mitochondria. So that is how in fed condition, neither there is breakdown of adipose tissue, triglyceride, nor there is transportation. So fed condition, there will not be oxidation. Opposite context, fasting condition. What will happen? Glucagon is there. High glucagon is there. So what does this glucagon do? Glucagon will do lipolysis. Lipolysis. Then this lipolysis will generate fatty acid. And this fatty acid will come. And then fatty acid will enter into mitochondria. There is nothing to obstruct. So malonyl coenzyme A is not during fasting condition. It is not present during fasting condition. And that is why it will easily come enter mitochondria and then fatty acid beta oxidation will happen. So did you understand these two very important steps? One step is lipolysis and other regulated step is transportation of fatty acid into mitochondria. Did you understand? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. If you have understood, now let me, there will be feedback regulation also, okay? So you know, what is feedback regulation? Feedback regulation means this is A and this is B. So reactant will, what does reactant do to the reaction?
The reactants will activate.
Very good. So this is feed forward stimulation. And this product will
inhibit.
This is feedback inhibition. Very good. Thank you. So now you can easily understand what are the reactant in your fatty acid oxidant. Fatty acid oxidation. What are reactant? What is reactant? Palmitic acid. Palmitoyl coenzyme is a reactant. What is product?
Acetyl CoA.
Good. Acetyl CoA. And then what else? ATP. ATP. NADH. Aren't the product? FADH2. These are all product. Okay. So this all will inhibit the reaction. If concentration of acetyl coenzyme is very high, ATP is very high, NADH is very high, they will inhibit the reactions of beta oxidation. And if palmitic acid is very high, it will stimulate the reaction. So simple logic, this logic applies here. You can see this all, this ATP will inhibit, ATP and NADH will inhibit beta oxidation. Okay? And then fatty acid will activate beta oxidation. And this is the same reaction shown that malonyl coenzyme A actually inhibit the entry of fatty acid here. Okay? Malonyl coenzyme. So this is the regulation that this AMP kinase will regulate this. So we have already done this during fatty acid synthesis. Did you understand this and feedback regulation?
Yeah.
I will ask question from this and this only, okay? So remember these two steps, very important step. One is lipolysis, other is citrate shuttle is regulated. Citrate shuttle is regulated. Citrate shuttle is a regulated step. That is, citrate shuttle means transportation of fatty acids, regulated step. And other step is lipolysis. Two steps are regulated step. So,